Hello, everybody. My name is Henry Chisholm, and you're watching Beyond the Arc. In this week's episode, we're going to be looking at players and teams trying to fight back into playoff positioning this upcoming week and throughout the rest of the season. We've got Tyler Bisack, who's returned from a concussion for Fairfield Warde and has averaged 20.9 points per game in 11 games this season. But first, we're going to start off with Bullard-Havens. They've got 5 wins right now and 6 more games remaining. They need 3 more wins to qualify for a playoff spot. So far, it's been a learning experience for Bullard-Havens, but the players are confident that they can make a run for the playoffs.
We play hard, like every night we play hard. It's just some nights shots don't fall. Lacks a big on defense, man. We have a couple of easy ones. We don't talk as much as we should.
Bullard-Havens was able to put everything together in a win against Platt Tech on January 26th.
And that win against Platt Tech was a nice win, simply because they had beaten us the first game of the season. And the kids made plays that night. It was the first game of the season that they really made plays when they needed to.
Helping to lead Bullard-Havens this year has been point guard Carlos Colon, Andreas Thompson, and a few others.
Well, my performance this season, I've been trying to push my team ahead. Like, first, my team comes first, than me. I mean, if I had to take control sometimes, I try to get into it, but I have to give them a ball first in order for my blood to start flowing on the floor.
Carlos Colon has had a couple of nice games for us, scored 22 against Caner Tech. We've had Sammy Ortiz, who came back to the team and has contributed. Sammy was one of the reasons we beat Wilcox Tech up in Meriden a couple of weeks ago. And senior Matt Ramos had a nice game against Platt Tech, knocked out a couple of threes. So each of these guys has at least contributed a little bit in helping us have some success this year.
And Bullard-Havens has 6 games left. They have to go 500 in these last 6 games if they want to qualify for the Class M playoffs.
Oh yeah, it's a goal. What we need to do is we need to get it down together, get it packed. Like, we got to talk more on defense and we got to be more committed on the defensive side of the ball. We give it too many easy buckets.
Well, this group of guys, they battle hard out there. Sometimes it's not our nights, but we always focus and try to get in the next game.
So Bullard-Havens is 5-9 going into this week's games. They've got Caner Tech on Tuesday at 6 o'clock at home. And on Thursday, they play at O'Brien Tech at 6 o'clock. Caner Tech defeated Bullard-Havens on January 14th, 69-56. So Bullard-Havens is trying to get back into the swing of things. And one player who's already gotten back into the swing of things is Tyler Bisack from Fairfield Warde. After suffering a concussion a couple years ago, he's battled back and is leading his team in scoring and trying to lead them into the playoffs as well.
I mean, I've been playing pretty well. A lot of hard work in the offseason, but it's mostly about my teammates around me. We practice hard every day. They're great guys. I just feed off them. So,
you know, he's averaging about 21 points a game. We didn't know he would do that well. We knew he could play, and we knew he would help us a lot when he came back. But 21 points a game is a lot of points. There hasn't been anybody here in this building who scored that many points in quite some time.
He said he suffered 2 concussions in his sophomore year. The first playing football in 2007 in December, and the second came playing basketball early in 2008. After the concussion, he didn't play another game that season, missing 16 games, and he also had to miss 5 months of school.
I think it started with football, and I didn't know I had a concussion. Mm-hmm. And then I got an elbow to my head in a JV game 2 years ago. Mm-hmm. And then I was just out. Just like a bunch of symptoms.
Wow, like what?
Headaches, blurry vision, dizzy. It was crazy.
And while out from school and sports, He had to undergo a couple of tests and spend a lot of quality time by himself with no television.
You just gotta take like compact tests, which like basically sees where your head's at right now. It's just like a computerized test, like memory and all that stuff. After I took that, I took that like six times. You just gotta stay home, just rest, no TV, no nothing.
Wow.
Just sleep, eat, that's it.
And after playing all of last season, which was his junior year, he started off his senior year again on the bench for the first four games of the year.
It was actually, I had to miss like four games because of eligibility or something because of last year. Because I missed like a couple games last year from a concussion. So it was, I don't know, it was like a bunch of stuff with the FCX and stuff.
And in his return, he's helped the team stop a seven-game losing streak last week against New Canaan. He's also going to play a big role in them trying to make it to the Class O playoffs. They just need two more wins.
We don't have to hold the other teams under 50 points to win. We still want to hold teams under 20. We know we can win now if we don't. Because, we have three kids who are averaging double figures, and the fact that he's back scoring about 21 points a game, it gives us a lot of confidence.
I think just playing a lot in the offseason. I mean, I'm obviously not playing football no more. Just kind of playing basketball, playing AU ball, playing with a bunch of guys, playing around, pick up games, anything. I just like to play.
Fairfield Warde plays Danbury this Tuesday at 7, and then they play Darien on Friday at 7. Both games are at home for the Mustangs, who need just two more wins to qualify for a Class L playoff spot. So make sure you enjoy all the games this week. Thanks for watching Beyond the Arc with Henry Chisholm, and I'll see you guys next week.